If you want a really easy way to bait out some really dumb comments from people that very clearly didn't read past the title and have no idea what the topic is even about, make an article and title it something along the lines of Intel spots a 3888.9% performance improvement in the Linux kernel from one line of code. You'll get comments like, AMD is cooked. Why would anyone go with AMD now? What real world applications does this actually affect? And of course, wow, what a terrible clickbait title, but this title is not inaccurate. Now, it's framed in a way that is definitely going to bait out some dumb comments, but it's not lying. The article I'm talking about is this one from, of course, Foronix. I love Foronix, but man, the forums on Foronix, they're a place of wonder. Now, this article is in reference to this kernel commit. MM and mmap limit the THP alignment of anonymous mappings to PMD align sizes. But that performance improvement number came from the Intel kernel test robot, which noticed a 3888.9% improvement of willitscale.perprocessops with that commit we just mentioned. This was done on a pretty crazy Intel machine that had an Intel Xeon that had 224 threads and 192 gigabytes of memory to work with. So, you know, a pretty standard machine that we're all working with. But when we're talking about percentages, it doesn't really matter that it's a really powerful machine. But what's important to know about percentages is they don't necessarily translate to crazy performance improvements even when you see numbers like this, right? So if you have a situation where an operation is run once every 10 seconds, and before any improvements, it takes 0.01 seconds to run. It doesn't matter how much you improve that by, whether it's 50%, 100%, 100 million percent, if your starting point is 0.01 seconds every 10 seconds, it's not really gonna matter. But if it's something run all day at 1,000 times a second, even a small percentage improvement can have a major impact. Now, I'm not saying this is either of those extremes, but keep in mind, anytime you're talking about performance and percentages, you need to understand how those percentages are being applied, because a percentage in a vacuum is very, very easy to mislead a viewer. Now, the earliest report of this that I can find isn't from an application being affected, isn't from the kernel bug tracker, but is actually from the SUSE bug tracker. On OpenSUSE Tumbleweed, kernel 6.10 THP causes abysmal performance drop. We regularly run spec CPU on a number of machines as compiler quality benchmarks. From time to time, we update the system of those machines, and some of them run Tumbleweed. The most recent update of a couple of them caused the Cacdu BSSN benchmark and some others to drop performance by 600%. Yes, a 6-time slowdown. This is a lot more important of a number to pay attention to. Yes, it is a benchmark, and yes, benchmarks are just approximations of real-world workloads, and sometimes performance drops in a benchmark might be a lot bigger than anything you see with an actual real-world workload, but 600% in a benchmark is still really bad. And if you're seeing 600% drop there, the workload it's trying to approximate is gonna have some sort of drop. Now, others did have a hard time fully replicating the issue, only seeing a drop of upwards of 50%, but even so, 50% is really, really bad, and that still shows that this is reproducible. The variation of the runtime for that benchmark is normally less than 1%. A slowdown of 50% is not quite as excessive, but it's very, very significant. And for instance, we work years in the compiler to get a benchmark like this to speed up by 5%. The 600% is merely so beyond anything comprehensible that it makes for a good subject of bug reports. But even a 10% drop in this case would still be noticeable. Now, some people went ahead and tested it on one kernel version and tested it on another. On one kernel version, the problem wasn't there. On the other, it was there. So clearly it was a problem with the kernel, and clearly the problem needed to be bisected. That commit found was by Rick Van Reel. MM, align larger anonymous mappings to THP boundaries. Align larger anonymous memory mappings on THP boundaries by going through THP get unmapped area if THPs are enabled for the current process. So THP stands for transparent huge page. So basically the idea is, instead of the normal memory pages, normal blocks of memory, you can request massive chunks of memory, and in certain applications, this can be an optimization. With this patch, larger anonymous mappings are now THP aligned. When a malloc library allocates a 2 MB or larger arena, that arena can now be mapped with THPs right from the start, which can result in better TLB hit rates and execution time. And this is a 3-line change. Technically a 2-line change, because this one is a comment. This is a 2-line change that is at least attempting to be an optimization and may have had the complete opposite effect. Now, what I've neglected to mention is, in the OpenSUSE report, this wasn't found on an Intel machine. This was on an AMD EPYC machine. We have other people testing on Intel machines, they found the problem there, but someone also on an AMP Ultra. So this wasn't at all an Intel problem, this was affecting everyone. But at this point, it was only being shown in a benchmark. So if it's just a benchmark and no real world applications are affected, yeah, that's a problem, because maybe something in the future could be affected, but not a super big deal. But someone did find a real-world issue. Just a few weeks after this report was made, another report was made on the Darktable application. This is something that a lot of you've probably never interacted with, but it is a really cool piece of software. Basically, it's an image editing tool, not in the context of Photoshop, more aligned with something like Lightroom. Now, it's saying it's not a free Adobe Lightroom replacement, but it does effectively serve the same purpose. Performance regression with Atras module and newer kernels. The pixel pipeline processing with OpenCL disabled takes considerably longer with kernel 6.10.6 compared to 6.6.47. How bad, you might ask? Well, somewhere in the range of 15 to 25% performance loss in RAW to JPEG conversion. That isn't a crazy big deal on one file. Yes, it's bad, and yes, on a large file, it's a problem. But when you're working with Darktable, you're usually not dealing with a single image. There's lots and lots of images, and that's gonna add up real quickly. Now, obviously, this is a problem with the kernel, but I don't know why this is the approach that a Darktable developer took. Basically, sort of disregarding the problem and not really wanting to go and, like, look at any issue here and sort of being kind of dismissive of this. Like, okay, other parts of the program do not contain code that would trigger a regression in the kernel, so only this module is impacted. So what? We should, instead of developers of the kernel, understand what exactly is the nature of the regression they introduced, and figure out how to change the application code so it does not trigger a regression. I disagree, this is unreasonable. And that's a fair point, but like, I don't know why it's this aggressive against the problem. But as such, it got closed as not planned. But obviously, this user wanted the problem to be resolved, so they did go ahead and also make a bug report against the Linux kernel in their kernel bug tracker. Bisected performance regression caused by MM align large anonymous mappings on THP boundaries. Now, what's intriguing here is they were not able to replicate it on their Intel system, but they could replicate it on their AMD system. They thought it might have just been an AMD problem. As we saw from the other thread though, That's absolutely not the case. So it might be a specific hardware problem where certain chips are more affected than others, and maybe there was a regression, maybe there was a performance drop on the Intel system, but it wasn't as noticeable as on the AMD side. Unlike the benchmark, which had a 600% performance drop, this is only 15 to 25%, so something dropping by like 1 or 2% in a certain test, that I would consider within the margin of error, so it might not be noticeable in the context of Darktable. And as you may have guessed from the title, the commit that got bisected is the exact same commit we mentioned before. This led to a discussion over on the Linux kernel mailing list started by Thorsten Leemhues. Hi, Thorsten here, the Linux kernel's regression tracker. Rick, I noticed a report about a regression in bugzilla.kernel.org that appears to be caused by the following change of yours, that commit we were just talking about. It might be one of those, some things got faster, a few things became slower situations. Not sure. Felt odd the reporter was able to reproduce it on two AMD systems, but not on an Intel one. Other reporters did also find it on Intel, but not in the kernel bug tracker. Maybe there is a bug somewhere else that was exposed by this. So in the end, it felt worth forwarding by mail to me. Not tracking this yet, first waiting for feedback. Now, one of the responses is from someone over on the SUSE bug tracker. The exact regression varies per system. Intel regresses too, but relatively less. The theory is there are many largish allocations that don't have individual sizes aligned to 2 megabytes and would have been merged. That commit we were talking about before caused them to become separate areas where each aligned its start at the 2 megabyte boundary and there are gaps between. This gaps and VMA fragmentation itself is not great. But most of the problems seem to be from the start alignment, which together with the access patterns causes more TLB or cache misses due to limited associativity. Now, this person we're talking about here, they are the one who also came up with the fix that we saw at the start of the video. The fix itself is a single line. Now, it's split across two lines, but this could have been just up here and there'd be no issue. So, a single line change. Since the regression commit, a mmap of anonymous memory without a specific address hint and of at least PMD size will be aligned to PMD so that it can benefit from a THP backing page. However, this change has been shown to regress some workloads significantly. Number one reports regressions in various spec benchmarks with up to 600% slowdown of the Cactus B SSN benchmark on some platforms. The benchmark seems to create many mappings of 4,632 kilobytes, which would have been merged to a large THP backed area before the regression commit, and now they are fragmented to multiple areas, each aligned to the PMD boundary with gaps between. The regression then seems to be caused mainly due to the benchmark's memory access pattern suffering from TLB or cache aliasing due to the aligned boundaries of the individual areas. And there was another regression bisected to the same commit in Darktable. To fix the regression but still benefit from the THP-friendly anonymous mapping alignment, add a condition that the size of the mapping must be a multiple of PMD size instead of at least PMD size. In case of many odd-sized mappings like the Cactus BSSN creates, those will stop being aligned and with gaps between and instead naturally merge again. And this led to, again, a single line change. Now going back to that original Pharonix post, Intel spots a 3,888.9% performance improvement in the Linux kernel from one line of code. Yes, Intel did spot it, but it was not a problem on Intel. And yes, the kernel bot under a very specific situation did notice that performance improvement. However, you're not suddenly going to get 4,000 FPS playing Minecraft. So, it is technically not wrong, but this is why I do what I do. A lot of the time, people don't dig into the actual context of what is happening, and might say things which are frankly really stupid, even if the thing they read isn't actually wrong. But what do you think? Let me know your thoughts down below. Did you read this article and think it was something that it actually wasn't? Did you go and read the context yourself? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one over these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Sleep Pay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and always read the source.